Hello, hope things are going well for you today. We serve a marvelous God, don't we? And when we're walking in His will, He blesses us. So I trust that you're being blessed today. It is all about the choices we make. God's always faithful to His word. And as we do what He says, He blesses us. Kind of what we're talking about today. You've heard me say before in our services, do right. Do right till the stars fall. Every kid that's ever come through our school, or even when I was in Natchez, heard me say that. Bob Jones is the one that said that, Bob Jones University, the founder there. And he was famous for his chapel sayings. I wish I knew all of them, because there's the words of wisdom wrapped up in those Senate sermons. I was looking through an old Bible of mine the other day, and the fly leaf had a lot of different things written there. But this is one of them that caught my eye. It says, it's always right to do right. And it's always wrong to do wrong. But it's never wrong to do right. And it's never right to do wrong. That's true, isn't it? It's always right to do right. It's never right to do wrong. And God help us to do right. God blesses right. God blesses us when we do what He says. So we ought to do right. I know we have the old nature. I know we struggle with it. Every day is another battle. But as we walk in righteousness, as we do right, that's when we know the joy of the Lord. That's when we know the grace of God. That's when we know the blessings of God in our lives. The book of Proverbs is called the Book of Wisdom, or the Wisdom Book. I told somebody the other day something we did when our kids were teenagers. We gave them notebooks, and we would read a chapter in the book of Proverbs every day as our devotions. And we would choose different topics depending on their age, being parents, dating, those kind of things, whatever related to them. And Jackie and Mike and Stacy and I would all sit down and we'd fill out our notebooks and then we'd go over and we'd compare them. What we found in that chapter is amazing how it works. Amazing as you look at the book of Proverbs, how you see dating there, obeying parents, those kind of things. Well, you also find this, what we're talking about doing right. Let me give you some examples. In Proverbs chapter 10, verse 11, the Bible says, the mouth of a righteous man is a well of life. When you're dealing with a righteous man, listen to him. It's a well of life. God blesses that. It's not death. It's not foolishness. It's life. It goes on, chapter 10, verse 24, the desire of the righteous shall be granted. Because we choose right and we walk in that choice, God says, I'm going to do it. I'm going to grant it. In chapter 10, verse 28, the hope of the righteous shall be gladness. It's just because we do right. We can be glad in spirit, glad in heart, glad looking forward. How about chapter 10, verse 30? The righteous shall never be removed. Hallelujah. Chapter 11, verse 8, the righteous is delivered out of trouble. Because we do right, God delivers us when trouble comes our way. We live in a broken world. Trouble is part of it. We all face trouble. We all go through trouble. But the Bible says a righteous man is going to be delivered out of it. Chapter 11, verse 23, the desire of the righteous is only good. God applauds that. That's what God wants for us. Verse 28, the righteous shall flourish as a branch. That's a promise of God. He says you're going to flourish if you do right. Do right till the stars fall. Chapter 11, verse 31, behold, the righteous shall be recompensed in the earth. There's a reward coming in heaven. There's a reward right here. God says, this is what I'm going to do if you do right. If you choose right. Chapter 12, verse 5, the thoughts of the righteous are right. Well, yeah, I guess they are. Chapter 12, verse 7, the house of the righteous shall stand. You want your kids to serve God? You want to grow kids that love Christ? Be right. Do right. Do right in front of them. Not because you're trying to influence them, because you're right. Be right with God in your own heart. Watch it have an influence on your kids. How about chapter 13, verse 5? The righteous man hateth lying because he's right. Chapter 13, verse 21, the righteous shall be repaid. God keeps good records and He blesses us. Chapter 14, verse 32, the righteous hath hope in his death. Hallelujah. We go beyond the grave. We're going to be in heaven forever. 15:19, the way of the righteous is plain. It's not hard. It's not difficult choices. God says this is right. Do right. 15:29, he heareth the prayer of the righteous. And then the last one that I chose, chapter 23, verse 24, the father of the righteous shall greatly rejoice. Now, shall greatly rejoice. That's us, our kids. That's also us and our God, because he's our father and he rejoices when we do right. Now, the word righteous is found 53 times in the book of Proverbs. We've only looked at 15. Maybe you could do your own Bible study. Take a look there. But even these 15, it's enough to see that God blesses it when we do right. One day, we're going to stand before God. We're going to give an account. In that day, we'll be glad we did right. Do right till the stars fall. Serve God with your whole heart. God will bless that. Let's pray. Father, we need your grace. God, righteousness is not in our nature. It's in your nature. But God, you give us your nature the moment we receive Christ as Savior. And God, you're living inside of us and you want us to do right. So God, help us to be dead to self and alive to God. Help us to walk in righteousness that we may please you, that our Father would rejoice. God, give us grace, give us wisdom, give us courage, give us conviction. And God, help us to do right till the stars fall. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. God bless you and thank you. Praying for you.